this afternoon we conclude a three-game set with the San Francisco Giants. And Haas, we need one today because the Braves have lost four games on this road trip, three of them by one run. A little frustrating.
A little more than a little frustrating, and Craig McMurtry will try to play the role of the stomper today. He's 7-3 for the year. His pitching opponent, a veteran right-hander the Giants acquired over the winter from Philadelphia, Mike Kruko. What Atlanta's got to do is start hitting the baseball. Ernie, and another point, yesterday was the first time the Braves have had a lead going into the seventh inning and lost a game in some 33 games.
Better things today. Back with the starting lineups right after this word.
It's not just a race. It's a game. If they think I'm tired, maybe they'll make their move.
Bring out your best.
Then I'll make mine.
Bring out your best.
For the wise of life.
Bring out your best.
For the wise of life.
The best. You found it in yourself, and now you found it in the beer you drink.
Introducing the new front-wheel drive Toyota Camry. It does not have a fireplace, but it does have living room, elbow room, headroom, tow room, family room. For families who are a size above average, for families who like to spread out. There's lots of feet for your feet, lots of living room for anyone, and a tough new engine with quick pickup and great mileage. The new Toyota Camry, not just the family car, the family Camry.
Oh, what a family Camry! Toyota!
Ready to go. Brett Butler will lead it off. He'll be followed by Jerry Royce and then Claude L. Washington. Braves with the same lineup as yesterday, with the exception of the pitcher. First pitch is a ball low. Butler, 2-for-5 in the series. He has 11 hits in his last 32 times at bat. He has 2 stolen bases in the series. He's also been caught attempting to steal. Boy, what a day we've got. It's going to be over 40,000 on Jersey Day.
And for the fans who like to keep score quickly, following Butler, as Ernie said, Royster in Washington, Murphy in center bats fourth, then Chambliss at first base, Hubbard at second, Pocaroba catching, Ramirez at short.
And there's a high pop. Youngblood coming down from third. Makes a catch.
And McMurtry does the pitching, and there's your Braves lineup.
The Giants will have LeMaster, Youngblood, Evans at first, Clark and right, Davis, Leonard, May, Wellman at second base, Kruko pitching. Just about the same lineup they had yesterday, with the exception of the battery. Brenly started yesterday. Royster hits it, pass first, base hit. And, of course, Youngblood playing third today, was at the hospital yesterday as his wife presented him with a new bouncing baby, a little gal, Joel Youngblood. Their second child. There's Kruko. He was out with a bad elbow. He was on a disabled list. Interesting note, when Kruko came back, his first start, they said, well, you're going to throw 75 pitches. Let's use that as a round figure. At the end of 75 pitches, he had a six-inning no-hit, no-run game going against Cincinnati. And they said, we don't care. Out you come. He understood. Washington the batter with a runner at first and one out. Curve is low. Claudel with a home run in the series. He's 1-for-4. He's at safely in 11 of his last 13 games. His home run yesterday came to dead center field. Murphy also hit one, but the Giants came back with home runs in the 8th and 9th, back-to-back, Davis and Leonard to win it. 1-0, hit toward LeMaster and by him. Royster's going to try to make third, and he will make it. First and third, and one out as Washington hit one just out of the reach of a diving Johnny LeMaster. So the Braves have something going here in the first inning.
Batting fourth.
If LeMaster gets to that ball, it's a double play because it was very sharply hit, but it just did get under his glove, as you're about to see.
The batter, Dale Murphy, 2-for-8 in the series. Homered here to right field off Andy McGaffigan, the third home run he's hit off McGaffigan this year. In fact, over the years, Murphy has hit Giant pitching very well. I don't know if anyone has hit more home runs against the Giants in the short career that Murphy's had, 23 homers against San Francisco. Curveball in there.
Look how their infield plays him. He's got the whole right side to work with. If he can just guide a ground ball through there, we'll have a run and still runners at first can third. Look at the hole.
He took a shot at it, too. They pitched him outside, and Murphy tried to hit a grounder or hit the ball on the right side. A little surprising because he's hit so many balls on the right side, most of them into the seats this year. But Krukow was a great addition to this pitching staff of the Giants. They got him from the Phillies for Joe Morgan. 0-2, pitch out. They thought something was on. One ball, two strikes. Skip Carey and Ernie Johnson with you from Candlestick. Pete's over on radio. We're working with a three-man crew today. John Sterling back in Atlanta for his TV show tonight. Krukow with a 1-2. Outside throw to first. Washington back. Krukow has a peculiar place to stop in the set position, but we've mentioned this before. It makes no difference where you come to a set position in your stretch. He comes right off his letters, almost in front of his face. Some come way down to the belt. Just long as you stop. Runner going. And he's got it. Stolen base by Claudel. He just ran on Krukow, took a chance, and May didn't have a chance. Stolen base, Claudel. So now Atlanta with runners at second and third. 3 balls and 2 strikes. He will not whine. He got it. Murphy down on a slow curveball. That's a big strikeout for Mike Krukow.
The bottom drops out on this one. If he takes it, it's ball four, but a great pitch by Krukow.
Chambliss the batter. A 3-2 slow curve.
That was a Stu Miller special.
Yeah. Now everybody backs up for Chambliss. They play him a little toward left center. The wind right now is blowing straight out. Royster third, Washington second. Ball outside. Hubbard's on deck. They'll pitch very carefully to the left-handed batter, Chambliss, I would imagine, with a righty coming up. There you can see the direction of the wind. Not strong yet. Up the middle, base hit. One in. Here comes CW, and he'll score easily. It looked like Chambliss swung at a ball. It was high, but he got enough of it to drop it into center field. It stopped rolling out there in the grass. A two-run score, so Chambliss picks up Murphy, knocking in two.
Yeah, the pitch is, well, it's a strike. He hung a curveball, really. He hit it just off the end of the bat, but got enough of it, was strong enough to guide it in the center, and a good start for Atlanta.
The second baseman, Glenn Hubbard.
So Chambliss at first, and 2-0 Atlanta. Stolen base helped.
So the two-out hit.
Oh. First person to congratulate Chambliss will be Murphy. Hubbard takes the strike. In baseball, if you fail to deliver in the clutch and the next fella hits, first thing you say is, thanks for picking me up and thanks for picking a club up. Could have been a poor inning if Chambliss didn't deliver. Hubbard fouled it away. Hubbard's hit safely in 5 of his last 10 trips to the plate and has a 3-game streak, 4-for-8 in the series, so he's coming out of that slight slump that he was in. Everybody gets in slumps, and usually it's just a matter of time before you get out of it. Towards second. Wellman the first. Hubbard retired, but not before the Braves picked up two big runs. They scored twice, top of the first, and the Giants are coming to bat.
The biggest game is on today. The whole town's got a part to play. But the hard work you do makes a kid's dream come true. And there's something big waiting for you, for you. Cokie's it, the biggest taste you've ever found. Cokie's it, the one that never lets you down. Cokie's it, the most refreshing taste around. Cokie's it, Cokie's it.
The airline that doesn't plan for the future may not have one. 5 years ago, Eastern saw the future in a remarkable aircraft. Now it's here. The new Boeing 757. The most advanced, most fuel-efficient commercial jet ever built. It's going to help Eastern hold down the cost of flying for years to come.
We're Eastern, America's favorite plane to fly.
Weeknights at 10 Eastern, award-winning interviewer Sandy Freeman goes beyond the news to meet the people making the news. Freeman Reports, weeknights on Cable News Network.
This telecast, authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the Atlanta Braves, intended solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the Atlanta Braves and the Turner Broadcasting System is prohibited. The announcers for this event are employed by the Turner Broadcasting System.
Very, very fine job.
Thank you. Better than yesterday.
Yeah. You saw the lineup to the Giants. There you see Craig McMurtry. Before we go any further, a happy Father's Day to all dads. We want to extend a couple of special ones. We can't mention all that have asked. Harold Football of Florence, Alabama. 50 Paget, 4 City, North Carolina. The Kesslers of San Jose and the Kesslers of Denver and St. Pete. And all other dads. Cure day, settle back and watch the Braves as they battle the Giants here at Candlestick. The weather just absolutely gorgeous as LeMaster takes low. McMurtry looking for his first win since back on May 25th when he shut out the Pirates. He's lost a couple since then and had two games where he wasn't involved in the decision. Ball low. Youngblood's on deck. Braves had a big chance yesterday to pick up a game on the Dodgers. As Valenzuela lost, that doesn't happen often. He's now 8-3. Reds beat him. They play again today. The Braves are still 4.5 out of first. The Giants are now 9.5. You'd think they were about 2, the reaction of the fans here, but they know that this is a team that can get back in contention. Pitches outside. Giants got good personnel. And they also know that the Giants have a lot of luck in beating the Dodgers last season and this season. 3-1. LeMaster, 1-for-6 in the series with a stolen base is at first. He has 20 stolen bases this year. And here's Joel Youngblood, 1-for-2 in the series. He's had 6 hits in his last 10 at-bats. Now they start to clap. There's going to be some noise here today with over 40,000. Pop foul. He tried to steer that down the right side. This crowd today will put the Giants over a half million for the year. Evans is on deck. McMurtry shooting for his 8th win. His ERA is 3.13.
the other baseball for you, Montreal beat the Mets 4-3. Philadelphia is clobbering Pittsburgh. It's 12-1 after 7.5. Cincinnati got a run in the first at Los Angeles. Houston failed to score in the first at San Diego. And the Cubs lead the Cardinals 4-1 after 7.5. American League, Cleveland in the first game of a doubleheader beat Detroit 7-2. A rain delay in the second game. Toronto beat the Angels today 6-1. Milwaukee trails the Yankees 7-3 at the end of six innings. White Sox lead Oakland 1-0 after 6.5.
An 0-2. Popped him foul down the right side. It's out of play.
Baltimore has a 4-1 lead, 4-0 lead, excuse me, over the Red Sox. That's after 7. Seattle leads Kansas City 2-1 after 6. And Minnesota plays at Texas tonight. That's all the other baseball up to the minute.
DeHart, thank you. We'll keep you posted, especially on that Red game. Reds and Dodgers. Cincinnati up by a run early. Here it's 2-0. Atlanta, runner going. Low throw. Safe. The master now, 21 stolen bases, one of the leaders. He has stolen 7 straight without being caught. That's a good jump. Pitch is low. But Poco came out of there throwing, but he beat it easily. So the Giants with a runner in scoring position. The leader in stolen bases is Steve Sachs. He has 24. Nothing new to report out of New York. George Steinbrenner fired Art Fowler, who's the pitching coach of Billy Martin. He's been the pitching coach for Martin just about every place Martin has managed. Martin not too happy about it. Bouncing ball, McMurtry, nice play. And he gets him at first. Got to be a good athlete to do that. McMurtry got high into the air, and the fact that he's 6'4 also helps.
He makes a fine play here. Takes a look at second, then figures he has to hurry to first, and he almost threw it over the head of Chambliss. He just did get up to get that ball.
Big ovation for Darrell Evans. He's 2-for-7 in the series. Billy Martin's status with the Yankees still up in the air, I guess. They say no danger of being fired, but you've heard that story before. Strike called on one.
Frankly, it's getting to the point where you almost don't care. That's been such a circus up there.
It's a 5-year contract, I believe, and he's about 2.5 months into it. Howdy doody with 18 homers. Murphy leads the league with 19. The 0-1 just missed outside with a sinker. Evans has knocked in 44 runs, having one of his best years at age 36. Final year of his contract, too, so for him, couldn't come at a better time. Slow curve in there. Evans has a good eye. He started that winning rally off Garber, walking on a 3-2 changeup. And Chili Davis hit one out to tie the game yesterday, and Leonard followed with a home run almost to the same spot, right field, and won it. Ken Daly pitched well yesterday. Pitched into the sixth inning, allowing only 2 runs. That was a 2-run homer by Jack Clark. In fact, he struck Clark out twice. Clark is on deck. McMurtry being very careful. Tomorrow night's game will be on Braves radio only. From Houston, Falcone will go against Rule. Bouncing up, we've got a full count. Tuesday, Nitro pitches against Scott. Wednesday, Pascual Perez faces Nolan Ryan. Thursday's off, then we come to you from Cincinnati next weekend.
from Tuesday against Houston.
Three balls and two strikes. Can't get together on the side. Now Poco's going to go out and say, son, what do you want to throw? And the fans boo. Great day for a sunburn if you sit in the sun here. If you're in the shade, you'll probably have a coat on. Ready to go with a payoff. Swung on, hit foul. He gave him a fastball. And Dutch Rennick gets a new supply of baseballs. Ed Montague is making the calls at first. At second base, Lanny Harris. Big Lee Wire is at third. 3-2 once again. Missed with a curve. That was close. Now Jack Clark with runners at first and second.
Number 22.
Clark with a six-game hitting streak. He has a couple of hits in this series, and both have gone the distance.
Coming in, McMurtry had just walked 28 men in 83 in a third inning, so two walks in the first inning, very unlike him.
Clark Whitty started his career as a pitcher. They saw him swing the bat, and they said, that's all. Get off that mound. There's a foul away. It happens often. We've had some outfielders start as pitchers. Pitchers start at third base. Like
Mike Marshall.
Bob Forsh was a third baseman.
Mike Marshall, yep. The old Dodger and Brave relief.
The 0-1. One ball, one strike. Runners first and second. You've got LeMaster at second and Evans at first. Curve way outside. 2-1. Clark has 12 homers. Now Bob Gibson out to the hill.
Got close to capacity here too on Jersey Day. A heck of a crowd for the Giants.
Kelly Davis is next. Gibson talking with McMurtry. No one loosening in the Rhino's bullpen. The Braves scored twice in the first inning. Royster had a single, Washington a single and a stolen base, and then Chambliss a big two-out hit. Good for two. McMurtry with walks has gotten himself in trouble. One on hit. Foul past third. He might have broken his bat. He's taking a look at it. Ball jammed him. And I think it cracked the bat. Clark, who played in the major leagues a few games at age 19. He's not that old. He's been around a few years. He's had some disputes from time to time with management here. But he produces on the field. First and second, and there's one out in the bottom of the first. McMurtry trying to get a grounder out of Clark. Royster, this is a double play. He hit the daylights out of it. Royster grabbed it going to his left and flipped to Hubbard for the double play. As we go out, take a look at this. This ball was hit right on the nose. Game of inches, you said it. Loescher to his left. Easily doubled LeMaster. So we go to the second inning. Braves 2, Giants nothing.
Yankee Willie Randolph, he does it all. Pro photographer Fred Conrad, he catches it all with his Canon AE-1 program. So advanced to capture Willie's sheer grace at second base. So much camera to follow Willie all the way home.
Hey, can I try your Canon?
Sure, it's simple.
In sun or shade, it's a snap to use. The Canon AE-1 program, so advanced, it's simple. Canon, the official camera of the Atlanta Braves.
All water is not created equal, so bring your pool to BioGuard for a free analysis.
I brought my pool.
Came to the right place.
Think you can clear it up?
Iron, 12 tests, feed it into BioGuard computer.
Just been blasting it with chlorine, you know.
Follow this formula step by step.
When's the next visit?
Anytime, always free.
Bring your pool to your BioGuard dealer. We'll find the formula just right for your pool.
Nice meeting you, big guy.
The Red Man Reaction. Satisfaction.
24 hours a day, CNN covers the world. CNN is immediate. For major events, CNN goes live to the scene. CNN is worldwide from its bureaus around the globe. Report for report, CNN is more news and information than anyone else can offer. 24 hours a day, CNN is the news.
Pocaroba takes the ball inside, 1-0. Poco 1-for-2 in the series. He'll be followed by Ramirez. Benedict's being given a couple of days off by Joe Torre. Bruce is okay. Look at that little Ephus pitch. Slow curve.
Joe, that like the game Poco called yesterday, which doesn't mean he doesn't like the way Benedict does it, but he thought he'd give him another look.
Popped him up. Back this way. 2-1. Hold it foul. Count goes 2-2. Kruko with pretty good control, but it hasn't always been that way. We looked at this press guide notes about Kruko. 2-2, inside. He once pitched a no-hitter for Cal Poly. He walked 17. Didn't say anything about run, but they said he pitched a no-hitter. There's a bouncer out to Wellman. One down. He's been a good major league pitcher. Last year, he was one of the most effective pitchers on the Phillies as Herm Sterrett goes out to talk to him. Might have said, hey, how come you threw that little slow curve out there? Is feeling well? Ramirez with one hit in the series. Kruko last year won 13 ball games with the Phillies. I was surprised, frankly, with his record last year, ERA 3.12, 13 wins, 11 losses, that they could afford to trade him. I don't care who they got in return. They got Joe Morgan. But the Phillies always seem to be needing some starting pitching. Look at that slow curve. One out, second inning, 2-0 Braves. Fastball hit to third. Raffy hit it well. Youngblood caught it. Now Craig McMurtry.
You know, Kruko had some pretty good years with the Cubs, considering a bad ball club. He had earned run averages over there of 3.91, 4.20, 4.39, 3.69. And that's pitching in Wrigley Field. You add one to...
Who said it? He's lost a couple in a row. He won his first three after coming off the disabled list. 2-2 on McMurtry. Lifetime against the Braves, he's 4-4. He's trying to get out number three here in the second. He got it. Strike out. At the 1-2-3, we go to the bottom of the second. Braves are up by two.
Always know what they like. Winners dress to win, and winners are wearing bike sports apparel. It's for everything you do. Bikes bringing out the winner, bringing out the winner in you.
Winners wear a bike, winners wear a bike.
Bikes bringing out the winner in you.
Winners wear a bike.
At leading sporting goods stores everywhere.
In the next 5 years, one home in 23 will be damaged by storms. One in 20.
Chili Davis leads it off. You go to the bottom of the second. One of the heroes yesterday with a two-run homer. Tied the ball game. Davis, just a baby, really. He's born in 1960s, 23 years old. Born in Kingston, Jamaica. But McMurtry's going to have to hurry, and he just got him. Davis beat out a bunt yesterday.
That exists.
As you look at it again, and he bunted it pretty well. If he bunted it a little harder, he'd have beaten it out. He gets down the line in great shape. McMurtry throws him out. If anybody has a three-bedroom house or a three-bedroom apartment that they want to rent for 2 or 3 months, Mike Jorgensen will be moving his family down and looking. Just call the Braves office as close in as possible, he says, to the ballpark, because he doesn't know his way around on time.
Call the PR department. Leonard swings and misses. Leonard 2-for-7 in the series. Big home run in the bottom of the eighth to win yesterday. Mike beat Mailer 8-4.
Mike's not a swinging bachelor, so don't worry about that. He's got a wife and kids that will be occupying that house or apartment.
Toward Chambliss. Over quickly, Craig McMurtry for the out. Two down, bottom of the second.
Number seven.
Rick Mailer got a win today. Richmond beats Charleston 8-4. Mailer now 5-2.
Rob Brace from Decatur, Georgia here rooting for the Braves today. Some fans from Rock Springs, Wyoming. John and Lynn Carr watch on the cable all the time.
The batter, Bill May. Lines it to center. Kind of a soft line drive. Nonetheless, a base hit to center for Milt May's first hit in the series.
Marge and Renee Peterson from Jordan, Montana are here. Gary Lenners and Rich Miller from Fallon, Nevada.
Here's Wellman, 1-for-6 in the series. McMurtry wants him. He'd like to have the pitcher lead off in the third. Fouled away, 0-1.
The Stewarts, Kimbrels, and Butlers from Waycross, Georgia vacationing out here. Gene and Marvin Brown and Ann Dunhu are here.
Pitch gets away and down to second base goes May. At first blush, it looks like Pokorova should have caught that ball. We'll have another look at it.
It sailed on him. I don't know if he was crossed up, but he might have flagged it down.
He's charged with a pass ball. Pokorova pass ball, a runner in scoring position. Curveball's outside, 2-1. We're playing in the bottom of the second. Atlanta leads 2-0. They got three hits in the very first inning. Royster, Washington, and a two-out single by Chambliss. McMurtry delivers inside, 3-1. He doesn't want to walk this guy. He's the eight hitter. That would bring up the pitcher.
And Kruko's hitting 353, so that's another reason not to walk.
And as we mentioned, he started as Beckett, Hubbard, and he'll make it. Wellman bounces to second, so he gets to face Kruko in the bottom of the third. We go to the top of the third, 2-0 Atlanta.
Weekdays on Superstation WTBS, meet the men and women who are setting the South on fire with their greed and passion, the Catlins. Step into their world weekdays at 11:05 Eastern, 8:05 Pacific time on Superstation WTBS.
We're going to the third. Butler leads it off. He fouled to the first baseman, make it the third baseman first time up. One ball, no strike. He'll be followed by Royster. Butler had a good game yesterday. Down low, he doubled, stole third in the fifth inning, later scored. Made a great catch in left field. Had a bunt single in the seventh. Two all. Out of the strike zone.
Tom Smith, our director today, and his parents, Sonny and Bobby Smith, celebrating their 35th wedding anniversary.
Our best wishes.
And headed for Hawaii.
Three balls, one strike. Heading for Hawaii, huh? I took Lois to McDonald's. Pitch outside. Butler walks.
Well, I'm not going to have to worry because I'll never make it that long anyway.
Doesn't two count?
Yeah, maybe if I put them together. Phillies beat the Pirates 13-1. That's a final now. The Cubs with Dick Ruthven pitching beat the Cardinals 4-1.
Royce to the batter, single first time up. He was not sacrificing. He was trying to beat that out. How about those Cubs? They won today 4-1. Yesterday beat the Cardinals 10-1. They're only four games out of first place. Right now, they are only three games out of first place. Winning again today.
Dodgers have tied the Reds 1-1. San Diego 1-0 over Houston. They're both in the second inning.
Have won six, now seven out of their last 11. You think we're hearing a few holy cows up there in Chicago?
Wouldn't it be great a Braves Cubs playoff?
Yes, sir. Butler coaches the throw. Washington on deck. Braves trying to add to their 2-0 lead. Kruko goes outside. It's kind of a short arm delivery. He doesn't bring the ball way back as Maxwell flashes signs. This is speed at first and speed at the plate. Out of the way.
Ernie enjoyed visiting an old friend of yours, Ed Kane, a sports announcer down in Tampa, Florida.
Yes, he's sports director at our affiliate down there and also does it Tampa Bay Bandits, I believe.
Rowdies.
Rowdies of soccer. I'm sorry. Tampa Bay Rowdies. Runner goes. Out of there. Ronnie Harris Harris waited a bit, and here comes Joe Torre, and he didn't like the delayed call either. Caught stealing. 2-6. Torre is going to talk to Lenny Harris about it.
Well, now we'll all get to umpire. They had the pitch out on. The throw just a little high. And Butler is...
Brother, that could have been called safe just as easy as out. And I think that Lenny Harris, the fact that he waited a while before he called it, really brought Torre out of there. Could have been called either way if we look at the replay the same way you did. And Torre's still fuming about it. Take a look where the tag is now, and take a look at Butler's foot.
Looks safe to me, but yep. Very, very close. I can't blame an umpire for missing that. If he did.
Caught stealing, 2-6. You brought out a good point. They called for a pitch out, and he almost threw a strike on it. Toward LeMaster. What a quick release he has. LeMaster doesn't bring the ball back either. He just flips it from a short arm and gets it to first in no time at all. Watch how far he brings this ball back or his arm back.
A big roundhouse curveball again. Throws it like a catcher almost.
Mm-hmm. And Patini, who plays third sometimes, throws the ball the same way. Therefore, they can bobble a ball now and then and they get it in the air in a hurry and still get you at first. Washington the batter. That curve took forever to get up there. He got one over. He'd been fooling around with that little Ephus pitch. The 0-1. Down low. Too. Speaking of umpires, if John Kibler is looking in today, lives in Arizona, we hope that he's feeling better. And we'll be back working shortly. Low again.
I asked Blake Cullen about John a couple weeks ago, said he was coming along fine. The only problem with him was he wanted to get back too soon. That's a good sign.
2-2 pitch. Might have been a foul. Let's see. Or a check swing. No one seems to know.
They asked for help. Lee Weyer just nodded his head no rather okay. than
go through all the actions. So it's a 3-2 to Claudel. That's a foul. Can tell that.
Either that or Milt Mays decided to start catching with his mask.
It off, takes a ball outside. It's Frank Robinson, the manager of the Giants. Well, what a player he was. 586 career home runs. He's in the Hall of Fame. Outside. Another fact about him, he was hit by pitch balls 198 times. The record is 243 by Ron Hunt. Ron Hunt sometimes tried to get hit, but Frank Robinson, who was the most valuable player, no other player has ever done this, in both leagues, hit 198 times. I know why he was hit. He used to hang that left elbow right over the plate. He batted close to the plate because he could hit the inside pitch. That's a strike. And he was voted into the Hall of Fame along with Hank Aaron last August. 3-1, 3-2. And one other fact about Robinson, a lot of superstar players want to start managing in the major leagues right away. He managed in the minors, managed winter ball, and learned the game from the bottom up. And he's done a good job over here. Three balls, two strikes. You're right. Fruco takes a pretty good cut. Stays at 3-2. LeMaster's on deck. Working for a walk. Doesn't want any jacket. He's acting like a regular. Didn't want to slow him down. So McMurtry walks a pitcher. Sometimes that doesn't work out too well. We'll see in a moment. LeMaster, who also walked, is at the plate. That's a third base on balls by Craig McMurtry. He's usually not that wild. 0-1. We could devote a half hour talking about coming from AAA to the big leagues, pitchers and outfielders, other position players. We could devote another half hour to being a pitcher on a pennant contender and being a pitcher on a last place ball club and a hitter. There is a difference, and someday we'll talk about it, a big difference. No balls, two strikes. Toward Royster. One. Safe at first. LeMaster runs well. They almost got him. And Kruko went into second base with the slide.
You see it again here. Jerry gets the ball to Hubbard in good shape, and he turns it as quickly as he can, but LeMaster really scampers and beats the rim.
Now Joel Youngblood. Tom O'Malley plays third most of the time, but Friday night he was hit by a pitch, and he twisted his ankle going to the ground. He said today that he should be ready to play tomorrow, or maybe even pinch hit today. You get the feeling the Giants are going to be right in this thing before it's all over. They're 9.5 games out of first, but they have good personnel. Single a right. First and third. Youngblood steered it through. He hit it just good enough. Here's Darrell Evans with runners on the corner.
He gets sawed off here a little bit. Hits it right off his thumb. But he hit it in the right spot. It rolls dead in the outfield grass before Washington can get to it.
The Dodgers are now leading the Reds 3-1 after two innings. Here it's 2-0 Atlanta. They've got runners on the corners. With one down. Just outside, 1-0. The runners are LeMaster at third and Youngblood at first. They both run well. Fouled away at a breaking ball inside. Darrell Evans a batter. Clark is on deck. Playing Evans to pull just a tad. 1-1, low. 2-1.
Well, that walk to the pitcher always comes home to haunt you, doesn't it?
Seems like it always gets you in trouble. Inside with a curve. 3-1. Now the bad one, they're loaded. 3-1 from McMurtry. Runner going, swung on line, foul, pass first. Ooh, that was close. The bullet, pull foul by Darrell Evans.
That was close in a couple of respects. It was close to being a double that would have tied the game with a runner going. It was also close to being a double play. Chambliss just did miss connection.
Now it's 3-2. So if they send him on 3-2, 3-1, I'm sure he's going here on 3-2. Going, pitch, swung on, looping, hit center field. A run in, Youngblood to third. Another base hit that wasn't really cracked, but hit just good enough. It's 2-1.
We can hardly complain about it. It's the same kind of hit Chris got to drive in the two Atlanta run. Just over Hubbard's, out of Hubbard's reach. And the tying run is at third, the go-ahead run at first, and there's still only one out.
Now Jack Clark. Evans at first, Youngblood around a third. He was going on the pitch. Gray's back at double play depth. Inside. One ball, one strike. The hits are even at three. You don't go for a strikeout, but you'll welcome one in a spot like this. And in fact, many times you will try for a strikeout in this situation. But it's not good to go for them. They'll come if they're meant to. By the way,
again, they sent the runner. They are playing wide open baseball here today.
Donnie Moore starts to throw in the Braves bullpen. There you look at Donnie Moore. Well, they know Polka Robles had throwing problems. That's another reason they're sending him. Polko doesn't have the strength in that arm that he had before his rotator cuff problem. One ball, two strikes. Davis is on deck. We're in the bottom of the third. The Giants with runners at first and third. One out. It's 2-1 Atlanta. McMurtry delivers a high fly. Short right center. Murphy, can he see it? He's got it. The tag. The throw is going to be off target. Youngblood gambling. And Evans also tagged and with the second. A good throw and he's dead at the plate. But Murphy had a little problem with a fly ball in short right center. I think the sun bothered him. And he might have been surprised that they sent Youngblood and his throw was off target.
He saw it for a moment, was late getting the glasses down, then really wasn't set to make the throw, and it sailed way up the third baseline, as you see. He was out by three steps with a good throw, but credit the Giants with aggressive base running.
So it's 2-2, and Evans, meanwhile, tagged at first and went to second. Fouled away by Davis.
And they will charge an error to Murphy on the throw bouncing away from Polka Roba, allowing the runner to get to second base.
One. And he does. That's out number three, but the Giants have come up with two. As we go to the fourth, it's a 2-2 contest.
Skip Carey, Pete Van Wieren with you now as we go to the fourth inning, and Dale Murphy leads it off against Mike Kruko. Fastball a little bit low, one ball, no strikes. 2-2 our score, the hits are even at three. Had a good cut, but didn't get the fastball, it's 1-1. After three, the Dodgers 3-1 over the Reds. Dusty Baker, a homer, Hooten against Bereni in that one. Charlie Hudson won his first major league game as Philadelphia beat Pittsburgh 14-2. Larry McWilliams, the loser. Foul back, it's 1-2. Steve Rogers won his ninth game as Montreal beat the Mets 4-3. Rusty Staub and Al Oliver at homers. Jeff Reardon his 10th save. Ed Lynch, the losing pitcher. San Diego 1-0 over Houston after three. Knepper against Hawkins. And Dick Ruthven for the Cubs beat the Cardinals 4-1. Dave LaPointe, the loser. Count evens, two balls, two strikes. In the American League, Cleveland 7-2 over Detroit in the first game. Second game rained out. Toronto beat California 6-1. Dave Golts now 0-6 for the Angels. Strikeout for Kruko, the second time he's gotten Murphy one away, and here's Chris Chandler.
The Yankees. Kruko has struck out Dale Murphy with the same pitch both times, an off-speed breaking ball.
The Yankees making it tough on George Steinbrenner to fire Billy Martin. They beat Milwaukee today 8-3. Britt Burns a three-hitter as Chicago beat Oakland 1-0. Baltimore 6-3 over Boston. Jim Palmer got a win. Line, center field, base hit. Chili Davis over and up with the ball. Chambliss is 2 out of 2. And that's the first Atlanta base runner, or the first Atlanta hit, rather, since Chambliss singled back in the first, driving in the two Atlanta runs. So Hubbard bats with a runner at first and one out. One other American League score to pass along. At the end of eight, Kansas City leads Seattle 4-1. Minnesota plays at Texas tonight. Hubbard bounced to second his first time. They play him shaded slightly toward right in the outfield. And he corks one to deep left field. Let's see if it's got enough carry. I don't think so. Leonard on the track. 2-0. Hubbard flirted with the ball, long ball, but at the fringe of the track, it was hauled in by Jeff Leonard. So Pocaroba bats with a runner at first and two out. The game, Pete, I was talking with Ed Kane, sports announcer for WPLP down in Tampa. And he was talking about the rivalry between Tampa and St. Petersburg, about where a park for Major League Baseball would be built. Breaking ball hit sharply, but right at LeMaster. He'll take it himself, and the inning is over, and we'll talk about that when we come back. Nothing doing in the Atlanta fourth inning. A Chambliss single is wasted. We go to the bottom half with your score. Atlanta 2, San Francisco 2. Jeff Leonard will lead off the Giant fourth inning in a 2-2 game. Getting back to that Tampa-St. Petersburg thing, apparently factions from both great towns are... First, the pitch to Leonard all the way to the screen. He is all over the place today. One ball, no strikes. Are warring as to where a stadium should be built. I wish they'd get a compromise together and work together to get one. What a natural rivalry with Atlanta.
That would be a great place for a Major League Baseball franchise.
And I hope if it happens, it's National League, because we wouldn't mind going there. Took something off the curveball, Leonard out in front. And all the fans from Vero Beach when the Dodgers are there, from West Palm when the Braves are there, from St. Pete when the Mets are there. But be a gold mine. The 1-2 pitch. Got him with a breaking ball. There's the first strikeout of the day for McMurtry. It was walk three.
If he can stay ahead of the hitters, he'll pick up more strikeouts today. When you fall behind, you have to pitch differently. He sets him up for that curveball with a couple of fastballs prior to it. Now there's one out.
And Milt May will bat. He singled his first time. 2-2, our score in the fourth. Good play by Chambliss. What else is new? Oh, that's an E1. That's the second time that's happened in this series, and about the eighth or ninth time this year.
And I wonder if Craig McMurtry is okay. Dave Pursley and Joe Torre headed out that way to see if McMurtry is all right. Here's the play again. Chambliss makes a nice stop just inside the line. And his throw looked like it caught McMurtry on the bare hand. And now trainer Dave Pursley and manager Joe Torre are out there making sure Craig's all right.
Yeah, you're right. You can see him flexing his pitching hand, and now he'll probably get a few pitches. That's the second error of the day for Atlanta. And he'll see how it feels. It's still hurting him, as you can see.
Appears to be his thumb that he's flexing.
I think he's saying he's all right. Now the Joe Torre wants him to throw a breaking ball, which should have hung, frankly. That was a little better. And he's going to stay in there.
Let's take a look at that play one more time. You'll see the good stop by Chambliss. Now, on the throw, McMurtry, instead of getting the glove out there, tried to catch it with his bare hand. You could see him shake the hand as soon as the ball struck it.
Well, here's Brad Wellman with the runner at first and one out. And Craig has to pitch around his own error. A potential go-ahead run at first base. Runner going. It's low. Poco's throw. He is safe. Ramirez can't hold it. Milt May, of all people, steals a base.
And that's Milt May's first stolen base of this year. The throw by Pokorova kind of tailed away from second base to the right. That is only the third stolen base in Milt May's major league career, which dates all the way back to 1970.
The stretch. Wellman waits the pitch. Over the outside corner, a sinker, and the count evens at 1-1. May at second with one out. A ball and two strikes, the count. If they're not capacity today, they're right at it. Huge crowd is gathered on Jersey Day in Candlestick Park. Just missed low with a breaking ball. 2-2, the count. He's running full again, 3-2. The pitcher, Mike Krukow, is next, but he is a tough out, hitting at 353 on the year. payoff pitch due Brad Wellman. Fly ball, center field. Murphy battles the sun and the wind. Two out. But you can't let up on Kruko. He can hurt you. A lifetime 225 major league hitter coming into this year.
Number 39.
The question occurs to me. If they put a major league team in the Tampa St. Petersburg area, where would that team go for spring training?
Phoenix or Vancouver or something. San Juan. Maybe they wouldn't go anywhere. He didn't get the breaking ball, 0-1. Did he go? They asked for help. Yes, he did. 0-2. That Montague made the call from first base. So now McMurtry within a pitch of getting out of this if he can make a good pitch to Kruko. That time, 1-2, the count. He had a good cut, fouled it back, and it stays a ball and two strikes. If the Los Angeles Dodgers travel all the way to Vero Beach to train, the Tampa St. Petersburg or St. Petersburg Tampa Cup might train in Los Angeles.
Makes sense.
Still 1-2, the count.
Yeah, I think we should try to get two more National League teams, one in Tampa and maybe one in Honolulu.
Or Las Vegas. That should end the inning. Hubbard in, up, and the inning is over. So the air does no harm. No hits, no runs, one air, one left. At the end of four, your score. Braves 2, Giants 2.
It's a half hour filled with today's sports scores, sports people, and highlights. Number watch 16. CNN Sports Tonight every weeknight at 11 p.m. Eastern, only on Cable News Network.
Rafael Ramirez will lead off the Atlanta fifth inning. He lined hard to the third baseman Youngblood his first time. Mike Kruko ready to go to work. He had a shaky first inning. He has pitched well since. That's downstairs. One ball, no strikes. And again, Kruko delivers. There's a good breaking ball. It's 1-1. At the end of four, the Dodgers lead the Reds 3-1. Side of the fastball, 2-1 the count. Kruko, a real dart thrower. He'll pitch like Stu Miller for a while and then zip that fastball by you. Cork to right, but Clark fades back. One out. Ruffy hit it well, but Clark moved to the fringe of the track to make the play. One away from McMurtry, a strikeout victim, his first time. 2-2, our score. We're in the fifth. Lynn and Brad Miller would like to be remembered to their fathers, Charles Douglas in Atlanta, Chuck Miller in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. The pitch to McMurtry, pop foul back and out of play. The Mitchell Hunters from Raleigh, North Carolina are here. Jackie Grease is here from Maui, Hawaii. And Bill Elliott from Atlanta wants to be remembered when the folks back home. 0-1, the count to the Atlanta pitcher. Fastball high, it's 1-1. Braves got their runs in the first. The Giants responded in the third. We're tied 2-2. Right at Brad Wellman, who fields and throws, two out. and the top of the order, and Brett Butler will hit.
Number 22, the left fielder, Brett Butler.
Butler has popped to third, and he has walked. He takes a little extra time, of course, to let his pitcher get back to the dugout for a little R&R. And now we're ready to go. High and away, one ball, no strikes. Wind blows at the moment toward right field. 2-0 the count. The ball gets away from Milt May. We're in Houston tomorrow night. Pete Falcone against Vern Rule. It will be on Braves radio only. By contract, WTBS unable to carry that game. But we'll have the Tuesday night Phil Niekro, Mike Scott matchup and Wednesday's Pascual Perez, Nolan Ryan duel for you. Then the Friday doubleheader and the Saturday Sunday game from Cincinnati. The 2-1 to Butler. It's high, it's 3-1, and Kruko for some reason made that pitch off the stretch.
Looks like he's going to pitch that way again.
Well, either he knows something I don't, or he's just changed his whole act here. Well, now he can pitch off the stretch for a reason. Second time he has walked Butler in the game. Brett was out stealing his first time.
Number one.
And Jerry Royster will hit.
The third baseman, Jerry Royster.
Now, I know he wasn't doing that all day, don't I?
No, he just started doing it against Brett Butler. Might be, just feels more comfortable that way. Some pitchers have been known to do that. Not many starting pitchers, though.
Suter or Raboski. It's inside, one ball, no strikes. Goes the runner. It's high and inside the throw, and this time he is safe. So Butler's one out of two in the stolen base department, and he's in scoring position with two out.
Stolen base number 14 of the year for Brett Butler. He got a big jump that time on Mike Kruko. May unable to get too much on that throw, and Butler in easily.
Giants argue that Royster swung at the ball. What he did was do all he could do, louse up Milt May behind the plate. But the count stays 2-0. And Frank Robinson has at it with first base umpire Ed Montague. So a base hit now could play to an Atlanta run. And it does. Butler will score easily. Royster with another RBI, and the Braves reclaim the lead. Royster drives in his sixth run of the year, his second of this series.
Well, this is what speed can do for a ball club. You get the stolen base from Brett Butler, and Royster follows it up immediately with a line drive single in the center field. Atlanta now with five hits and a 3-2 lead.
Washington singled, stole a base, and scored in the first, struck out in the third. One, the count. He had a good cutter, a fastball. It's Tough to say goodbye to this town. This
pretty good spot.
The stretch. It's inside 1-1. No check it. Called it a strike. 0-2 the count, my mistake. Royster at first, two out, a run in. He's going. The pitch bounces away. Royster slides into second, and he will have a stolen base. Or will he? Now time called by Dutch Renner.
Royster also gets a good jump on Mike Krukow, who has a little bit of a slow motion when he delivers the ball to the plate.
Renner had to check with the third base umpire to make sure that ball did not deflect off Washington's bat. It did not. 1-2, the count. He got him with a breaking ball, and the inning is over. For the second time, Washington out on strikes. Krukow records his fifth strikeout of the game, but the Braves reclaim the lead. They get a run on one hit. No errors and a runner left. We go to the bottom half of the fifth inning with your score. Atlanta 3, San Francisco 2. Top of the order for the Giants in the bottom half of the fifth. LeMaster, Youngblood, and Evans will hit against Craig McMurtry, who has a lead once more. It's 3-2. Low away, one ball, no strikes. John Sterling not with us today. He is winging his way back to Atlanta for his sports program this evening on TBS. Come on, Craig. 2-0 to count. Three balls, no strikes. McMurtry, which is not like him at all, is Joel Youngblood. He tapped to the mound, inside outer to single to right.
Donnie Moore up again in the Atlanta bullpen, second time he's been throwing it.
And the only question in my mind is, will LeMaster try a straight steal or will they play hit and run? Donnie stole a base back in the first. Just about threw that one too tall for Chris Chambliss. Second, and the Giants are at it again. And they have the heart of their batting order coming up. Youngblood celebrating the birth of his daughter yesterday is 2 out of 3, and here's Darrell Evans. And here comes Bob Gibson. Perhaps to give Donnie Moore some more time.
Well, Craig McMurtry has been in trouble virtually since the leadoff hitter in the first inning, Johnny LeMaster, who walked back then. Giants had two walks in the first inning. They had a base hit in the second. Scored a couple of runs on two hits and a walk in the third. Milt May reached on an error in the fourth, and now a walk and a base hit here in the fifth.
After five, the Dodgers lead Cincinnati 4-1. Well, let's see how the Giants play it here. Evans has walked, singled, and driven home a run. And this may be the guy McMurtry has to get. LeMaster leads at second, Youngblood at first. 18 homers, 45 RBI. Nowhere near. One ball, no strike. Is next. And Evans in the driver's seat here with a 2-0 count. Is something bad about to happen? Yes, it's 3-0. Again, Evans looks at Danny Ozark, his third base coach. The wind is blowing hard now toward right. Let's see if they green light him here. 3-0. There's nobody out. Nowhere close. The bases are loaded with nobody out. That will be all for Craig McMurtry. Joe Torre is on his way. That's the kid's fourth walk. He appears to have pretty good stuff, but he can't find the strike zone today. Check it. That's his fifth walk. Moore comes in where? In a spot where there is absolutely no margin for error. The Giants have LeMaster at third, Youngblood at second, Evans at first, nobody out, and their cleanup man, Jack Clark, is marching to the plate, and he has lined into a double play and hit a sacrifice fly. As Donnie Moore warms up, we'll see how he does when we come back from this commercial message. Spot like this is he does throw strikes. He seldom has control troubles. He's walked only three men in 20 and two-thirds inning.
And he had his best outing with the Braves this year against the Giants. He shut them out for four innings to save the game for Pete Balboa.
The 0-1 to the right-hand hitter. It's 0-2. So Moore has him where he wants him, but he's a tough out nonetheless. Clark hitting at 252, 12 homers, 33 RBI. Chili Davis is next, then Jeff Leonard. Infield is back, but more at a halfway posture now. It's 3-2 Atlanta, but that lead is seriously threatened here in the Giant fifth inning. Into Pocoroba and the 0-2 pitch. High and away, 1-2. It's LeMaster at third. Youngblood at second. Evans at first. Miss low and away, 2-2. Moore really wanted that pitch. He thought he had him struck out. But Dutch Renner didn't, and he's the one who counts. The 2-2.
Fly ball, center field. Murphy going back. He's got it. A run will score. Youngblood races for third. He'll make it. Tie game. Drives in his second run of the day, and the go-ahead run is at third with one out.
And both of Jack Clark's RBIs have come on sacrifice flies to center field. This one was well hit. Back in the third, he hit a fly ball to very shallow center field, but the run was still able to score.
Now Chili Davis will bat. He is tapped to the mound and flied to center. They're on the corners with one out. Drilled right field. Washington coming on. He's got it. Another run should score. The third sacrifice fly of the day. And the Giants have the lead. Davis hit that a ton. It's 4-3 San Francisco. And Jeff Leonard will hit. Leonard at 247, 0 for 2 today. Now a runner at first. Two out and two in. It's 4-3 Giants. Runner going. Pitch inside. Pokorova can't make the play. And a stolen base for Evans. He's in scoring position. Third steal of the day for the Giants. Sending the runner back.
They're sending Evans back to first base as you look at the...
Must have foul tipped it, huh?
Replay of the stolen base. I guess they ruled it a foul tip, so he's back at first now. Take away the stolen base.
At least for the moment. He edges away again. The stretch. First, runner back. 0-1 is the count. Against the Braves, Leonard has a career average of 301. Again, they chase Evans back to first. Moore goes to the Rosenbach. If he gets Leonard, he will have at least kept it from being one of those big, big innings. Downstairs, it's 1-1. Runner at first, two out. Giants have scored two runs with just one hit here. The pace on balls will kill you. 1-2, the count to Leonard. The left-hand hitter, Milt May, waits to hit next. Evans goes. It's low. Deja vu, it pops away, and there's the stolen base.
Almost identical to the first time Evans went, except this time no foul tip. Pitch bounces off the plate, gets away from Pokorova, and Evans goes in standing, his third steal of the year.
Pokorova really had very little chance on that pitch. So an insurance run in scoring position with two out. Leonard calls time. Moore takes too much time for his liking. Bounced foul. It's still two balls, two strikes. Braves are 1-4 on this trip. They've lost three of the games by one run each. They trail by one run here in the fifth. Little tap is fouled on the third baseline. Count stays the same. Pete, correct me if I'm wrong, but we have not been swept in a series this year, have we?
No, nor have the club lost four in a row before. The Braves in danger of that hit as they trail 4-3.
Moore again looks in. Evans at second, two out. just outside with a breaking ball. He's got a left-hand hitter next, then a pretty good one, Milt May. So the pitch of decision due to Jeff Leonard. With a fastball. Leonard is out on strikes. Moore did his job, but the damage is done. Two runs on one hit. A couple of sacrifice flies, a couple of walks in the inning. There were no errors. One runner was left. We go to the sixth with your score. Giants 4, Braves 3. Well, Mike Kruko finds himself staked to a lead for the first time in this game. He trailed 2-0. He trailed 3-2. He now leads 4-3. And he'll face Dale Murphy, who has been a strikeout victim against him twice.
Let's make one correction. The Braves were swept, although it was only a two-game series against the Chicago Cubs at Wrigley Field.
That's right.
But that's been the only time.
Into the wind, Kruko, and the breaking ball fouled off. It's 0-1. Braves have out-hit them, but where it counts, the trail. The Masters should throw him out. He bobbles the ball, but still gets him one away. Had a little trouble getting it from the glove to the bare hand, but he handled it all right, one away. Murphy's 0-for-3. Here's Chris Chambliss, 2 out of 2. And he's driven in both Atlanta runs with a first-inning single.
The first baseman, Chris Chambliss.
Kruko ready to go to work. Got the corner on one. That's low, a ball on a strike. Richmond won their game today. Rick Mailer picked up his fifth victory. I think the score was 8-4. Bouncing ball. Look at the range that kid's got. Wellman throws him out. 2 down.
Well, Brad Wellman has been roaming all over Candlestick Park in this series, taking base hits away from Atlanta Braves hitters. This time, he's ranging wide to his left back of the outfield grass. We've seen him make plays behind the bag at second, showing equal range going the other way to his right. He's a good one.
Kruko just keeps rolling along, and here's Glenn Hubbard. He didn't get the fastball, 0-1. A ball and a strike to count. Ground ball, what a play. Youngblood throws, and the inning is over. And the Giant infield continues to sparkle. Youngblood took a double away from Hubbard with a backhanded play over the bag and gunned him down. No hits, no runs, no errors, none left. We go to the bottom of the sixth. It's the Giants 4-3.
Hulks that you love to love and love to hate. Don't miss the best of World Championship Wrestling coming up right after the game tonight on Superstation WTBS.
Okay, Milt May leads off the Giant sixth, and the fastball is a strike call. 0-1 to count. Do you write those promos yourself?
No, I don't. I just read them.
Whoever wrote that one obviously should live in this time. 1-1 the count. Infielder Dwayne Kuiper of the Giants celebrating a birthday today. A ball and two strikes. The count. McMurtry went 4 innings, 4 plus innings, allowed 4 hits, 4 runs, walked 5. That was his undoing. and struck out one. May waits. Into the dirt. Braves 16-6 in day games. But they're trailing here. We've got three more at-bats to do something about a one-run deficit. And Moore's 2-2 to May. Popped him up foul. It's still two balls, two strikes. Braves finally get home again a week from Tuesday against the Houston Astros. It's Johnny LeMaster's birthday too, the Giants shortstop. We would wish him a happy birthday, but since he doesn't speak to members of the media, he wouldn't answer, so it's sort of pointless. A payoff pitch to Milt May. Line right at Ruffy, one out. Boy, he hit that ball hard. May is out of there. And Brad Wellman will bat. Wellman not doing much with the stick, but boy, he can get it done around second base.
Brad Wellman.
With his defense, he's one of those players that he can just hit 250 or so. He'll be around the major leagues for a long time.
Right off his thumbs into the seats, it's 0-1. Moore once and gets a new baseball. To the young Giants second baseman. Low and away, 1-2 the count. Kruko, who has walked and bounced the second.
Number 39, the pitcher, Mike Kruko.
Kruko now at 333 on the year, about 231 for his career. Fouls that one back, 0-1 the count. It's 0-2. Still no balls, two strikes. Ryan Kingman up and throwing in the Giant bullpen. Steve Bedrosian goes to work for Atlanta. Throw it away, 1-2. There's Bedrosian on the message board. The Giants wish a happy birthday to June Fungal. Nice going, June. A 1-2 pitch. Foul tip back. It's still 1-2. It's Darrell Evans' anniversary today. Just full of interesting tidbits. Reading a big story on Darrell in the San Francisco papers. can't think what the word is now. When you look at the stars, what do they call that? You know, the stars, the moon.
Astronomy?
Yeah, he's into astronomy now. You can talk about that the last three innings as Truco strikes out to end the sixth. Moore records his second strikeout. 1-2-3 go the Giants, and we go to the seventh with your score. San Francisco 4, Atlanta 3.
Top half of the seventh inning, Pete Van Wern joined now by Ernie Johnson for the final three innings. Biff Pokerova, Rafael Ramirez, and then a pinch hitter for Donnie Moore. The Braves trail 4-3. Pokerova is grounded out, hit into a force play, 0-2. One ball, no strikes. Truco gave up two runs and three hits in the first inning. Since then, he's allowed only one run and two hits. And the count even on Pokerova now. One ball, one strike. Mike Truco trying to even his season record, seeks his fourth win of the year. Here's the 1-1 to Poco. There's that changeup, and it missed low, 2-1. Line drive center field, but right at Chili Davis. Had a little trouble with that ball, but was able to stay with it and make the catch. And that's out number one in the top half of the seventh.
Looked like the line drive acted like a knuckleball out there. As it went at Davis,
number 16,
he hung on and made the catch.
Now Rafael Ramirez is 0-2. He is lined out to third and flied to right. And he takes the first pitch high and inside. One ball, no strikes. Four runs, four hits for the Giants. Three runs, five hits for Atlanta. We're in the seventh. Line drive. Youngblood can't get this one into left field for a base hit. Maybe more than one. Ramirez rounding first. Going to try for two. Here comes the throw. He is out at second base. Another demonstration of the fine throwing arm of left fielder Jeff Leonard. It's a single for Ramirez. He is out trying to stretch it into a double. Leonard to Wellman.
It's a great throw by Leonard and a neat tag. Watch Wellman let Ramirez tag himself out. He just put it right down, and you notice that he had the back of his hand. In other words, he didn't have the inside of his wrist exposed to the spikes. Boy, you can really have a severe cut down there with those veins. So he just put the back side of his glove down and let Ramirez slide into it. And that's a great throw by the left fielder Leonard.
Now Terry Harper pinch hitting for Donnie Moore. Harper at 292 for the year with three homers, 18 RBIs, takes pitch high, ball one. We have really seen a display of fine throws by Jeff Leonard in this series. He threw out Terry Harper, in fact, trying to score from second on a base hit in Friday night's game. There's a line drive right at Wellman. Braves hit the ball hard in the seventh inning, but have nothing to show for it. No runs, one hit, nobody left. We go to the bottom half. It's still San Francisco 4, Atlanta 3. Bottom half of the seventh inning, the new pitcher for Atlanta right-hander Steve Bedrosian making his 29th appearance of the year. He's 4-2 with 9 saves, a 2.42 earned run average. In 48 and a third innings, he has given up 37 hits, 13 earned runs, only two homers. He's walked 18, struck out 46. Donnie Moore worked two innings, allowed no runs or hits, didn't walk anyone, struck out two. It's 4-3 San Francisco. Johnny LeMaster leads off the bottom of the seventh for the Giants. He's been on base every time up. Two walks, and he also reached on a force play. He has stolen one base and scored two runs on his 29th birthday. First pitch to LeMaster is taken low, ball one. Braves in danger of losing their fourth game in a row. That would be the longest losing streak by the Braves this year. They'll have two more cracks. Try to do something about this San Francisco lead. 2-0 the count. LeMaster Master, Youngblood, and Evans do up here in the seventh. Ball three, low and outside. 3-0 now on the Giants shortstop. Here's the 3-0 pitch, and LeMaster takes a strike, 3-1. Craig McMurtry started the game for Atlanta. He appeared to have pretty good stuff, Ernie. Just that control was the problem.
Then he got hit in the hand. I don't know if that had anything to do with it or not, but he put his meat hand into the glove on that throw from Chambliss.
Well hit to left field. Butler going back, looking up. This one's gone. Johnny LeMaster with his fourth homer of the year, and the Giants now lead it 5-3. Is only the third home run allowed by Steve Bedrosian this year.
Got the fastball and just whacked it out of here. LeMaster's not a home run hitter, but he got it down the line. And look at the people come out of those seats, all for that baseball.
Is hit number 5 for San Francisco. It's now 5-3, and here's Joel Youngblood, who's 2-for-3. A couple of singles and a ground out. He's scored 2 runs. Makes the pitch low, ball one. Now the 1-0 on the way upstairs for a ball 2-0. 5 runs, 5 hits for the Giants. 3 runs, 6 hits for Atlanta. Bottom half of the seventh. The 2-0 pitch to Youngblood is low ball 3, 3-0. Bob Gibson now out to the mound, trying to settle down Steve Bedrosian. He fell behind LeMaster 3-0, then threw a strike before the home run was hit. And now it's a 3-0 count on Youngblood. There is no activity in the Atlanta bullpen. Well, now there will be. Right-hander Rick Kemp is going to begin to throw. The meeting on the mound breaking up as Kemp goes to work in the Atlanta bullpen. There's the 3-0. Youngblood taking all the way, and it's low ball 4. Meanwhile, they're in the eighth inning at Dodger Stadium. Dodgers leading Cincinnati 5-1. Darrell Evans, the batter. He's walked twice and singled. His single drove in a run back in the third. Youngblood back safely. Evans fouls it back 0-1. If the Giants win this game, they'll just be 4 games behind Atlanta. And the team the Braves see next, the Houston Astros, have been playing much better baseball of late.
I think the Giants have a team is capable of being a contender. I think it's just a matter of time they get back in there, because they've got a lot of good talent.
The one strike pitch is outside, 1-1. Houston is trailing San Diego at the moment, 5-4 in the sixth inning. They are right at the 500 mark going into that game. And that's where the Braves head right after this game, to Houston. 2-1 the count now on Darrell Evans. Nobody out in the inning. Youngblood, the runner at first, gets back safely. Now the 2-1 delivery is fouled back, 2-2. All around San Francisco, they have write-in campaigns going to get Darrell Evans into the All-Star game. It set up distribution points for all-star ballots at shopping malls all over the San Francisco area. Pass them out here at the ballpark, too.
Can't imagine if they didn't have him on the original ballot.
Here's the 2-2, and there's a high pop-up, foul territory, third base side. Biff Kokorobo can't get to it. It's still 2-2. I talked with Darryl briefly about that yesterday, Ernie, and he said he thinks that the reason he was not included on the ballot is because nobody was really sure where he was going to be playing this year, whether he was going to play third base or first base, or he even played some shortstop last year.
Yes, but after you've been in the major leagues for over 10 years, you've got over 200 homers, and you should be listed there somewhere, even though, you know, take a chance.
2-2 to count on Evans. The runner going, the 2-2 pitch is inside the bag at first, down into the right field corner. Around third, Youngblood, they're going to wave him. Stopping down at second is Darryl Evans at 6-3, San Francisco. So the Braves' problems continue as the former Brave, Darryl Evans, drives in his second run of the game and his 46th run of the year with his 14th double.
This one's right over the bag. Picture swing by Evans. Chambliss didn't have a chance. It was just fair, and then it goes down to their bullpen. They scatter so that they don't interfere with it. Youngblood scores easily all the way from first. Here's Jack Clark, and Joe Torre's on his way. And it looks like they're going to make a change right now.
So Steve Bedrosian lifted here in the seventh inning after facing just three hitters, giving up a home run, a walk, and a double. So two hits allowed, two runs to this point. The runner at second, Darryl Evans, is Bedrosian's responsibility. One walk, no strikeouts. Making his way in from the Atlanta bullpen, right-hander Rick Camp will be the fourth pitcher to be used by Joe Torre today. And while Rick Camp warms up, we'll watch this. Rick Camp, the new pitcher for Atlanta. He is making his 17th appearance, his fourth in relief. He has a record of 5-7, 4.14 earned run average. He's allowed 40 earned runs and 92 hits in 87 innings. He has walked 26, struck out 39. He's been in and out of the starting rotation all year. Got off to a very good start this year, but has struggled lately as a starter, so he'll work some in the bullpen. And here's Jack Clark, who lined into a double play in the first inning, hit sacrifice flies to center in the third, and again in the fifth. Takes the pitch low, ball one. Six runs, six hits for San Francisco. Three runs, six hits Atlanta. Braves have made two errors. Now the 1-0 pitch. Line foul off to the right, 1-1. Braves in danger of slipping 5.5 behind the Dodgers. Dodgers leading in their game 5-1. They're in the eighth inning. And the Braves trailing here by three. Camp now steps off. Here comes the 1-1 pitch. It caught the outside corner for a strike. 1-2 now on Jack Clark. Giants manager Frank Robinson was concerned about his ball club when this series began. He said that nobody on the team except Darryl Evans was hitting. Well, that's changed the last couple of days, hasn't it? Here's the 1-2. Did he go? No. 2-2. Now Jack Clark wants plate umpire Dutch Rennert to examine the baseball. Dutch can find nothing wrong with it. Thank you. 2-2 on the way. In the dirt, good stop by Pokorova. Count full now, 3-2. Chili Davis in the on-deck circle. Braves scored first in this game. They got two in the first inning, but the Giants tied it up in the third. Braves then took a 3-2 lead in the fifth. But the Giants scored two in the bottom of the fifth and two here in the bottom of the seventh. And now lead at 6-3. Camp's 3-2 pitch on the way. Park gets a fly ball to deep right field. Washington going back. This one is gone. For the third straight game, Jack Clark has hit a home run. His 13th of the year. He's now driven in four on the day. He's driven in 37 for the year, and he's broken this one wide open. It's 8-3 San Francisco.
Let's see where this pitch was. Looked like he went down and got it. Look at that. He did. And he just drove it over that fence in right field. Washington went high into the air but couldn't catch it. And Clark has made it a five-run San Francisco game.
Close the book on Steve Bedrosian. You can charge him with three of the four runs. As the count on Chili Davis goes to nothing and one. Davis has bounced to the pitcher. Fly to center and a sacrifice fly to right. Foul back again, 0-2. Giants have been very efficient today. They've scored eight runs with only seven hits. Still nobody out in the inning. And the 0-2 pitch on the way, that misses inside. One ball, two strikes. Here's the 1-2 pitch. That evens the count 2-2. Well, unless the Braves can rally in the last two innings and pull this one out, they'll just have to regroup. Hopefully get things turned around in Houston tomorrow night.
There were some fans with I Hate the Dodgers t-shirts in Atlanta. Going to put out another brand after this series.
Count full now, 3-2 on Chili Davis. Giants have the Cincinnati Reds coming to town next. Here's the 3-2 bouncing ball right side. Hubbard makes a nice play. His throw to first, though, is over the head of Chambliss. Pokorova backing up. In all likelihood, that will be a base hit for Davis, and it is. Hit number 8 of the day for San Francisco. Hubbard made a nice play, but a nearly impossible kind of a throw to make.
Hubbard did a fine job getting to the ball, then his off-balance throw is high and outside. Be a base hit. Pokorova was backing up, kept him off second.
So two hits off camp now, eight off Braves pitching today. Here's Jeff Leonard. He's 0-3. He's grounded out to first and struck out twice. Davis back safely. That's fouled back, nothing and one on Jeff Leonard. Again throws to first. Again, Chili Davis gets back. Here's the one strike pitch, a check swing foul back off the screen. 0-2 now on Leonard. Leonard was the hero yesterday. His home run broke a 4-4 tie, gave the Giants the win in game two in this series. And two, the count on Leonard. That makes it 1-2. Now the 1-2 on the way. Fly ball, right field, pretty well hit. Washington. Washington has room for this one, though, and he'll make the catch for the out. Chili Davis, who was tagging at first, took a few steps toward second, but then returned. Now Milt May, who has singled, reached on an error, and lined out to short, batting with one out in the inning. Perhaps what Milt May will remember most about this day is back in the fourth inning, he stole a base. His third major league stolen base.
In about 12 years.
Mm-hmm. Now again, Davis back safely.
Well, he'll tell you he doesn't run to it.
Wonder if he was running on his own or... That's low for a ball. One ball, no strikes.
Almost time for funny stories, but for some reason I don't feel in the mood. This two-week road, have we been on the road 2 weeks? No, this is just 1 week. Another week to go, folks.
Here's the 1-0. Downstairs, ball two, 2-0 to count.
And it's hardest for those guys right down there in blue. They've lost 4 games, 3 by 1 run. Now they're trailing by 5 big ones.
Going, the 2-0 is fouled back by May. 2-1. Chili Davis will turn around, go back to first. Braves have played so well on the road for the last 2 years that it's been a long time since they've been through a spell like this. Last year, Atlanta actually had a better record on the road than they did at home, and this year, right up until today, the Braves playing 500 ball on the road, which is what you hope for. There's a ground ball to short. This might be two. Takes a bad hop. Gets by Ramirez. Around second, Chili Davis. He'll wind up at third. Runners at first and third, and the problems continue. They will charge an error on Rafael Ramirez, but it did look like the ball took a nasty hop as it got to him.
Well, we'll let the fans judge. Right at him. Took a little bigger bounce at the end. Couldn't handle it. First and third. One out for Brad Wellman.
That is the third error made by the Braves today. Wellman 0-3. He's grounded to second, flying to center, and lined out to second. And he takes a strike, nothing and one. Eight-3 Giants, bottom half of inning seven. Wellman, the eighth man to bat in the inning. One ball, one strike, the count. Now the 1-1. Line drive, base hit, center field. Chili Davis will score from third. Stopping at second is Milt May. It's 9-3. Wellman drives in his fifth run of the year.
Well, I guess we must take another look at it. Hit a breaking ball right on the nose. Just out of the reach of Ramirez. And now the Giants have batted around. Here's Kruko. And it's a 9-3 game.
Kruko 0-2. He's walked, grounded out, and struck out. Giants have scored 5 here in the seventh. And still only 1 out. Nothing and 1 to count. Terry Forster begins to loosen up in the Atlanta bullpen.
Joe would rather not use Terry Forster here today in a game that's out of hand because Braves do play tomorrow.
0-2 now on Kruko. We've had a home run by LeMaster, a walk to Youngblood, a double by Darrell Evans, a two-run homer by Jack Clark, a single by Chili Davis. Then after Jeff Leonard flied out, May reached in an error. Brad Wellman drove a run home with a single. Here's the 0-2 pitch. That's fouled away. Still nothing in two.
They score anymore, it'll just be about time to walk the dog. Bottom of the seventh inning, they've scored 5 times.
May leading off second, Wellman off first. The 0-2 to Kruko. Hits sharply. Hubbard diving stop goes to Ramirez for one on to first. Double play. Pretty double play turned by the Braves as Hubbard makes a beautiful play. But the Giants bat around in the seventh inning. They score five runs on five hits. There was one Atlanta error and one man left. They go to the eighth. It's now San Francisco 9, Atlanta 3.
Time to look at the Red Man scoreboard, National League. Montreal beat New York, Philadelphia scored some runs for a change. The Dodgers are beating Cincinnati. They go to the eighth, 5-1. Houston got four big ones in the fourth. The Cubs are only three games out of first place, beating the Cardinals again. And in the American League, you take a look at many completed games. A postponement at Cleveland in the second game between the Tigers and the Indians. We didn't talk too much about it, but Art Fowler was fired by George Steinbrenner. Billy Martin still the manager of the Yankees, but walking lightly, I guess.
Picked up a New York newspaper at the hotel this morning, and there's a tremendous column in there by George Vexey on the Billy Martin, George Steinbrenner situation. Brett Butler will lead off the eighth inning. He'll be followed by Jerry Royster and Claudio Washington. Braves need a bunch of runs. It's 9-3 Giants. Butler has popped a third and walked twice. He has scored one of the Atlanta runs. Well, Mike Kruko, who didn't get the lead until the fifth inning, now has plenty of runs to work with. Oh, and one on Butler. The curve misses inside. One ball, one strike. Here's the 1-1 pitch. 2-1.
What excites the Giant fans and their players is the fact that the past couple of years the Giants have played the Dodgers well. Last year they were 9-9 with them, but they beat them in the end when they had to.
Well, there's a start to the eighth inning. Butler lining a single to right field. Hit number seven by Atlanta.
The third baseman,
I think what the fans out here really like, too, is the Giants have really made an effort to improve this ball club the last couple of years. They made some controversial trades, which for the most part have worked in their favor.
Yeah, some fans forget the Giants were right in it to the last week of the season last year.
Greg Mitton goes to work now in the Giants bullpen as Jerry Royster steps in. Royster 2-for-3 with a run scored and an RBI. Third baseman Joel Youngblood over now to have a chat with Kruko. That is a strike. Royster was trying to step out and have time called, but he did not get out of there soon enough. So it's 1-1. Grounded to the left side. LeMaster goes to Wellman. It's safe at second, on to first. Safe at first. Rhett Butler thought he was out, and he began to leave second base. Third base coach Dow Maxville had to point to Butler to get back down to second. Frank Robinson's going to argue the call with Laddie Harris. The throw by LeMaster apparently pulled Wellman off the bag.
Let's watch. The master's throw, a little high. Looked like he was off the bag. We've seen that called a couple of times. Another angle now. See
where their second baseman is when he catches this ball. Tough to tell right there. First angle looked like he was in the air when he caught it. And right on top of it was Lanny Harris, and he said that he didn't have this foot on the bag. First and second for Claudel Washington.
Charge an error to Johnny LeMaster. The first error of the game for San Francisco. Washington has singled and struck out twice. Fouled back. Final score from Los Angeles. Dodgers beat Cincinnati 5-1. So the Braves in danger of slipping to 5.5 behind unless they can mount a big, big rally in these last two innings. That Dodger pitching continues to be just remarkable. Only one run given up today by Bert Hooten.
ERA about 2.6. Amazing.
The 1-1 pitch, now it's 1-2. Runners first and second, nobody out. Royster and Butler get their leads. And the 1-2 to Washington, high and tight, 2-2. Now the 2-2 on the way. Fly ball, shallow center field. Chili Davis coming in. And there's out number one. Washington flies to center. The runners remain at first and second, and Dale Murphy will step in. Murphy has struck out twice and grounded out to short.
Here we met a young writer, John O'Neill, from Sun Valley, Ketchum, Idaho, covering the game here and watching our games when we're not playing here. When he's back in Idaho, and wants to say hi to all his friends.
First and second, one man out for Murphy. Truco ahead in the count, nothing and one.
Even a Murphy can get tired. Big, strong youngster. He's played in every ball game, and he might be a little weary. He struck out quite a few times on this road trip. A couple of times today.
Count even now, one ball, one strike.
Trouble is, Murphy won't say he's tired.
No, and Joe Torre admits there have been a couple of times last year and one time this year when he really felt that Murph needed a day off, but he just can't leave that name off the lineup card. Here's the 1-1 in the dirt, 2-1. Butler off second, Royster off first. And the 2-1 pitch. One by him, it's 2-2. Truco really knows how to pitch. He changes speeds, works the corners. His fastball is really not that overpowering a pitch. But when he throws those off-speed breaking balls and then sneaks a fastball in there, he can get a by-hitter.
And he's not really fluid. He's kind of got a little peculiar motion the way he delivers the ball.
2-2, the count of Murphy. The runners lead from first and second, and the 2-2 pitch. It fouled off to the right. Tomorrow night will be on Braves radio only. Pete Falcone faces Vern Rule in the first game of the Houston series. Back with you on television Tuesday night. Phil Niekro faces Mike Scott in that one, and a dandy pitching matchup on Wednesday night. Pascual Perez against Nolan Ryan. The 2-2 taken low, ball three. One more bad one, they'll be loaded. Good speed on the bases. Braves are down though by six, so they probably won't be moving. They are not, and the 3-2 pitch is taken low, ball four. That loads the bases for Chris Chambliss, and here comes Frank Robinson. So a base hit, an error, and a walk have loaded the bases for Chambliss and have ended the afternoon for Mike Krukow. He'll get a nice hand as he leaves. Krukow working 7 1/3 innings. He has allowed 7 hits, 3 runs to this point. Of course, the runners aboard is responsibility. He issued 3 walks and recorded 5 strikeouts. Coming in to pitch for San Francisco, right-hander Greg Mitton.
Now pitching for San Francisco.
Who, along with Gary Lavelle, give the Giants one of the best righty-lefty combos in that bullpen. While Mitton warms up, we'll take time out for this word. Greg Mitton's had sort of an up-and-down year. He has a win, 3 losses, 8 saves, but his ERA is high at 4.79. This will be his 29th appearance. He's allowed 19 earned runs and 42 hits in 35 2/3 innings, 22 walks, which is high for him, and only 11 strikeouts, which is low for him.
They call him Moon Man Mitton. He's a little bit of a flake. I guess he's one time hid the bus so no one could find it.
Chris Chambliss, the batter, he has a couple of hits today. Yeah, the story they tell is that, I'm not sure in which city this occurred, but Greg Mitton went down to get on the team bus, got on the bus, told him that he was the only player going, so he might as well leave now. Left all his teammates behind.
That's Moon Man.
There's the 1-0. Bouncing ball slowly toward first, up with the Darrell Evans. His only play will be on the bag at first. Scoring from third, Brett Butler, and the other runners move up. So give Chambliss an RBI, his third of the game. And there you see the largest crowd at Candlestick Park ever to see a Braves-Giants game, 50,205.
Number 17, the second baseman, number 10.
Well, that makes it 9-4. Runners now at second and third for Glenn Hubbard, who has grounded out twice and flied out. Shallow center field. Davis coming hard. He'll make a diving try. Did he catch the ball? No, says third base umpire Lee Wire. He trapped it. 2-run score. And the Braves have pulled back to within 3. It's now a 9-6 ball game. Glenn Hubbard drives in, runs number 25 and 26 of the year, and the Braves are battling back here.
Hubbard hit a soft single to center. Davis almost caught the ball. Looked like it might have been a trap if he held on, but it was that close and appeared for a moment like he might have injured himself. Let's look at this angle. It was right around that glove. But the Braves pick up 2. It's 9-6. Runner at first, and here's Poco.
Pokorova, 0-for-3, is grounded out to second. Get into a force play and fly to center. Little tap to the third base side of the mound. Mitton will field. The throw to first is in time. And the inning's over. But the Braves pick up 3 runs on 2 hits. There was 1 San Francisco error. 1 man left. We go to the bottom half of the 8th. It's now the Giants 9, Atlanta 6.
This season, you can get the Braves Clubhouse collection of authentic apparel, gift, and accessory merchandise and souvenir novelties by ordering from a colorful 16-page catalog. Send $1 with your name, address, and phone number to Braves Catalog, Post Office Box 4064, Atlanta, Georgia, 30302. Your dollar will be refunded with your first order.
Johnny LeMaster leads off the 8th against Rick Camp and takes the first pitch, low ball 1. LeMaster celebrating his 29th birthday today, and he's walked twice, reached on a force play, and homered. He has scored 3 runs, driven in 1. And there's another base hit. Line drive in the left field. Butler almost had that ball get by him. And LeMaster reaches again. That is the 4th hit off Rick Camp. Hit number 10 of the afternoon for San Francisco. That'll bring up Joel Youngblood, who has bounced to the pitcher, singled twice and walked. He has scored three runs. Terry Forster will go to work again in the Atlanta bullpen. Youngblood Bunning pops it foul back toward the Giants dugout, 0-1. There's Terry Forster. Nine runs, 10 hits for the Giants. Six runs, 8 hits for Atlanta. The 0-1 with the runner going is low. Pokorova's throw will not be in time. Master has his second stolen base of the afternoon, his 22nd stolen base of the year.
That's a good jump. Too bad a throw, but he beat it. That is eight straight stolen bases for LeMaster. Hadn't been caught.
1-1, the count now on Youngblood. Now it's 1-2.
You could see Youngblood on that pitch, sacrificing himself. He just tried to hit an inside pitch to the right side to get a run at a third. Many players would do that all the time. Youngblood is one of them. They don't get any credit in the stats for it if they make out, but the manager knows that it's a sacrifice on his part.
Down at second, LeMaster leading. And a 1-2 pitch to Youngblood. Hit sharply but right at Royster. He looks the runner back, throws on to first in time. Now Darrell Evans. He has had another big day today for the Giants. He has walked twice, singled and doubled, 2 for 2, with a run scored, and 2 RBIs. He is now batting .313 for the year with 18 homers, 46 runs driven in. And it looks like Joe Torre wants to make the change here and get the left-hander Terry Forster into the game. In fact, he might be making a double switch. Bruce Benedict is also loosening up down in the Atlanta bullpen, and that will be the case. Both will be brought in. So Rick Camp will leave. He worked an inning and a third. Allowed 4 hits.
Your attention, please.
He has been charged with 2 runs to this point. The runner at second, of course, is taking responsibility. He didn't walk anyone in order to strike out anyone. So Terry Forster will be the new pitcher, and Bruce Benedict will also come into the game. Forster will hit seventh, Benedict will hit ninth. Forster will have 8 warm-up tosses. While he takes them, we'll watch this. So here are the Atlanta changes. Bruce Benedict into the game to catch. He'll bat the number 9 position, which is due up second in the 9th inning. And the new pitcher is Terry Forster, on for the 25th time. He's 1-1 with 8 saves, a 1.67 earned run average. He's given up only 6 earned runs and 24 hits in 32 in the third innings. He has walked 17, struck out 15.
Well, the 3 runs the Braves scored in the top half of this inning made Joe Torre go to Forster. If it had been still 9-3, I think Camp would have just finished it. But the Braves, if they can get out of this and repeat another 3-run inning, they would tie the ball game. It's a big, tall order, but the 3 runs in the 8th certainly helped them.
Darrell Evans, who along with Jack Clark have been the big villains here this afternoon. A long look back by Forster. Now he'll step off the rubber.
He's afraid of LeMaster getting too big a lead and trying to take third.
Now the pitch on the way to Evans. Way inside, ball one. One out in the inning, LeMaster at second. ...31-year-old Terry Forster. ready for the 1-0 pitch. Grounded to the right side. Second baseman Hubbard up with it cleanly. Evans retired. Over to third goes LeMaster. Two men are out. Jack Clark will be the hitter. He's had a productive day. After lining into a 5-4 double play in the first, he had a sacrifice fly to center in the third, a sacrifice fly to center in the fifth, and a two-run homer to right in the seventh. Four RBIs today for Clark.
You wonder if they'll pitch to him. We'll see in a moment. Davis is next. He's a switch hitter. He'd turn around and bat righty. But it's almost a question whether they want to pitch to Clark, who hits righty, or Davis, who hits righty.
Let's see what the Braves have decided here. They will intentionally walk Jack Clark.
Hear the boos from 50,000. Boo, boo.
So the intentional pass to Clark will put runners at first and third, and Jilly Davis at the plate.
What's so great about this game of baseball, Pete? The 50,000 fans, you got 50,000 managers here. Everyone likes to manage. They really get with it, and the Giants today went over 500,000 with this crowd. And momentum right now in favor of San Francisco, of course.
Here comes Jilly Davis, who has bounced to the pitcher, fly to center, had a sacrifice fly to right and singled, 1-for-3 with a run scored, an RBI. He'll turn around and bat righty against Forster. He's hit about the same both ways. 236 lefty, 237 right-handed. But he's had a lot more power from the right side. Six of his nine homers have been hit right-handed. One ball, no strikes. LeMaster off third. Clark off first. Forster ready now with his 1-0 pitch. Line to center field. Murphy going back, still going back. He'll reach up and make the catch to end the inning. So Terry Forster is able to keep the Giants off the board. No runs, one hit, a couple of men left. We go to the ninth. It's still San Francisco 9, Atlanta 6. Top half of the ninth inning. Braves trail by 3. Rafael Ramirez, 1-for-3 in the day. Facing Greg Minton. Nothing and one to count. Now the 0-1 on the way. Got by everybody. One ball, one strike. Bruce Benedict on deck, and then Brett Butler. In case Minton gets in trouble, the Giants bullpen is busy. Left-hander Gary Lavelle and right-hander Jim Barr are throwing. And the count now 2-1 on Ramirez. Dodgers won the day 5-1 over Cincinnati. Bert Hooten beat Bruce Perini. Dusty Baker hit his seventh homer of the year. Grounded right at the shortstop. LeMaster, he boots it, picks it up, and has no play. Perhaps that's a start to something here in the night. That'll be an error on LeMaster, his second error of the ball game.
And this is his second error in two innings. Very unusual for Johnny LeMaster. Kind of an in-between hopper, and he didn't come up with it. Here's Benedict.
Benedict batting for the first time, hitting .293 for the year, has one homer, 16 RBI. He's been in a little bit of a batting slump, although the numbers sound worse than the slump has really been. He's won for his last 24, but throughout the slump, he's hit the ball quite hard, just right at people. Inside, ball one.
Minton holds a major league record. He went about 281 innings without giving up a home run.
That's amazing.
It's an amazing thing, and throws a lot of balls low.
He's behind in the count, and Benedict now 2-0, and you can begin to hear some of the fans stirring just a little. At one time, the Giants led 9-3. Braves got three of the runs back in the eighth inning. That's a strike. It's 2-1. The right-hander is Jim Barr, the lefty Gary Lavelle. Now the 2-1 pitch. Line drive right field. Clark is going to make the catch, throwing back to first. Almost a double play. The throw pulled Evans off the bag. Again, Benedict hit the ball hard, but this time right at Jack Clark, the right fielder.
I thought he had a base hit. It held up for Clark, and
number
then Clark,
22,
who
the left fielder,
used to be a pitcher. He was signed as a pitcher. Shows that he's got a strong arm. He came close at first base, but the ball was a little bit off target. Ramirez got back.
Now Brett Butler, who has popped out, walked twice and singled, one for two officially. He scored two runs. Ramirez, the runner at first, not being held. Evans plays behind him. One ball, no strikes. If the Braves get one more base runner, get a chance to get down toward the heart of the order, perhaps.
Would be the tying run at the plate with one more base runner.
Here's the 1-0 pitch, and that misses low. Ball two. Mitten falls behind 2-0. Joel Youngblood over to chat with Greg Mitten. We've talked a lot about the young pitchers that the Kansas City Royals traded to the San Francisco Giants last year, guys like Hamaker, Lasky. Greg Mitten originally came from Kansas City as well. Giants traded catcher Fran Healy to the Royals when Mitten was a minor leaguer. Here's the 2-0, and that's outside ball three. 3-0 now in Butler.
Looks like he's almost trying to steer that 2-0 pitch over because he knew Butler was taking and he missed it. Wellman out at second from Kansas City. They got a lot of alumni here from the Royals.
Now the 3-0 pitch on the way. Butler takes a strike. It's 3-1. He may very well be taking the next pitch as well.
That's something I've never seen a pitcher do. After he threw that pitch over, he made the sign of the cross right on the mound. Batter's not Catholic.
Here's the 3-1. Caught the inside corner and the count full now, 3-2. Jerry Royster, the on-deck hitter. Ramirez is not running on the 3-2 pitch, which misses outside ball four, and the Braves will bring the potential tying run to the plate now as Frank Robinson heads toward the mound. He may make a change. That is the first walk issued by Greg Mitten.
Your attention, please.
The fourth walk of the day off San Francisco pitching. And Frank Robinson has already made the sign, even though a right-hand batter, Jerry Royster, is due up next. The guy that's been his ace in the bullpen this year has been Gary Lavelle, and he'll get the call here. So Mitten leaves after working one inning, giving up one hit, walking one. Gary Lavelle will have a chance to save it now for Mike Kruko. And while he gets ready to face Jerry Royster, we'll take time out for this. Gary Lavelle is having a fine year out of the Giants bullpen. This is his 30th appearance. He has won 5 and saved 9. And he has not allowed a home run in 44 innings of work. He got the victory in yesterday's ball game. He'll be facing Jerry Royster here with runners first and second, one man out.
Lavelle is a rare breed of a pitcher who spent 8 years in the minor leagues. And he was a starter all that time. And I just don't think they could corral that fastball of his over 90 miles an hour. When he came to the major leagues, they did help him with his control. And he's been an outstanding relief pitcher for years now.
Royster on the day is 2 for 4, a couple of singles, couple of runs scored. He has driven in one run. He represents the tying run. There's one out of the inning. Nothing on the count on the Braves third baseman. Claudel Washington in the on-deck circle. The Braves, as far as right-hand pinch hitters go, have a couple left. Randy Johnson and Bob Watson, there are your runners. Butler at first, Ramirez second. Inside, one and one. Larry Owen, also a right-hand hitter. Bob Horner on the bench, but he did not take any batting practice the last couple of days, so I don't think he's available to pinch in. Still nursing that bad ankle. Here's the 1-1 to Royster. Check swing foul off to the right, makes it 1-2. We've seen Frank Robinson manage a lot of games against the Braves, where he goes against the book a lot. He'll bring in a right-hand pitcher to face a left-hand batter sometimes if he feels that that's his hot man in the bullpen. Butler and Ramirez lead from first and second, and a 1-2 pitch on the way to Royster. Just missed low. That was close. 2-2. Now the 2-2 on the way. Ground ball right side. Look at that. Wellman run that ball down. That young man covers a lot of ground at second base. The runners advanced to second and third, but Wellman took a base hit away from Jerry Royster. Two outs in the inning.
He's been spectacular. I thought this ball had a chance, and he chased it down on the grass. Very calmly, right here on the grass, looks to second. Looks around a little bit. You know, he had no play at second. And fired to first in plenty of time. Now Watson will be called upon as they go with the percentages. Watson will bat for Washington.
Watson on the year hitting an even 400, 22 for 55. One homer, 16 RBIs. And he has been the Braves' premier right-hand pinch hitter. 4 for 10 with one homer and 5 RBIs coming off the bench. So Watson will be the batter with runners second and third. Two men out in the ninth inning, and the Braves down by 3. Gary Lavelle trying to save it for Mike Kruko. Bob Watson trying to get the Braves back in it. Lavelle delivers and misses with a fastball outside. Ball one. Watson uses a very heavy bat, heaviest bat any of the Braves use. There's the 1-0, low and inside ball two, 2-0. Dale Murphy is on deck. Right-hander Jim Barr continues in the Giants bullpen. Now the 2-0 pitch, swing and a miss of the fastball, it's 2-1. Frank Robinson, Herm Starrett looking on. They're one out away from sweeping the series. Here's the 2-1, bouncing ball toward short. Johnny LeMaster throws across to Darrell Evans, and the San Francisco Giants have done it again. In the ninth inning, for either no runs or hits, there was an error, two men left. And the Braves, for the first time all year, have lost 4 games in a row. Today's final, San Francisco 9, Atlanta 6. We'll be back with the totals right after this. Well, the Braves' road trip miseries continue. The Giants handing Atlanta their 4th straight loss this year on this trip. Final score 9-6. Ernie Johnson has the totals.
For the Giants, 9 runs, 10 hits, and 2 errors. The Braves, 6 runs, 8 hits, and 3 errors. Kruko, the winner, he's now 4-4. McMurtry, the loser, 7-4. And give Gary Lavelle his 10th save of the year. LeMaster and Clark hit home runs for the winning Giants. And they both came in that big 7th inning when they put it away with 5 runs. The winning RBI, Chili Davis with a sack fly back in the 5th inning. Final score, Giants 9, Braves 6. The Braves are now 1-5 on this trip. We continue on to Houston right after this game.
And with the Dodgers winning their game today by a final score of 5-1, the Dodgers now open up a 5.5 game lead over the Atlanta Braves, and the San Francisco Giants remain 9.5 out. They're only 4 games behind Atlanta. Tomorrow night we'll be in Houston. That game on radio only. We'll be back televising Tuesday night against the Astros, 8:35 Eastern time. Final score once again, Giants 9, Atlanta Braves 6. Coming up next, we'll join Championship Wrestling in Progress. Now for Ernie Johnson and Skip Carey and John Sterling, this is Pete Van Wieren speaking from Candlestick Park in San Francisco. So long, everyone.
Atlanta Braves baseball, America's team. Braves baseball has been brought to you by Bud Light. When you bring out your best, you deserve ours. Eastern Airlines, America's favorite way to fly, and the official airlines of the Atlanta Braves. Toyota cars and trucks, who remind you that it's a good feeling to buckle up for safety, so get the feeling whenever you drive. And by the people in your town who bring you delicious, refreshing Coca-Cola. When it comes to big refreshment, Coke is it. Canon, so advanced, Canon is the world's leader in 35mm photography. And by CNN and CNN Headline News.